Today, we will review the brand new DJI Mavic 3 for carrying a light, a vibration dampening system, and a 360 VR camera like what you see right here, the Insta360 One X2, and the GoPro MAX and Kandao Qoocam 8K. We will review some of the professional payload attachments from DJI Mounts and DPD Mounts, two very well-known brands in the community that can create silky smooth vibration-free 360 videos like what you see on my YouTube channel. We will teach you how to attach a 360 camera or any camera or a cinematic light like the Lume Cube right here safely on the DJI Mavic 3 and what not to do for a safe flight. We will test how much more flight time you can get compared to the Mavic 2 Pro. We will also cover how to hand launch and hand catch the Mavic 3 to avoid potential accidents. If you are thinking of using Mavic 3 or Mavic 3 Cine to carry camera, lights, and any payloads, this is the video for you. Let's dive right in. Hey, what's up everybody, it's your boy Hugh back from another in-depth review and tutorial. Mavic 3 or Mavic 3 Cine has really shocked the professional videographer community, for better or worse. The biggest feature is the dual camera setup right here with a Micro Four Thirds and telephoto lens. So why would you carry a third camera or anything on a Mavic 3? Well, the first practical reason is adding lights. You need light to film anything, no matter how big your sensor size. Carrying a small but really powerful light like the Lume Cube right here will help you control your ISO, reduce your sensor noise, and get better video in general, especially when you are filming in 120fps. The real reason though why you want to carry a third camera is to film in 360 for VR video, like all the video you saw on my YouTube channel here. You can look around on your browser or your phone, but the best experience is where you can watch this with a VR headset like the Oculus Quest 2 or right here, the Vive HD Vive Flow right here. Because of improved batteries, lighter body, and more powerful motor, Mavic 3 and Mavic 3 Cine right here is going to be able to carry a heavier 360 camera, or it can fly longer than the Mavic 2 Pro right here. DJI would never tell you how much more weight you can add to your Mavic 3 at takeoff, but at this test you are watching right now, we are carrying an 8K VR camera, the Kandao Qoocam 8K, and an Insta360 One X2 on top with no problem. The combined weight of all the accessory, stabilization, and cameras weigh 518 grams, and Mavic 3 handled nicely as you see right here. It floats in the air without any drifting, while Mavic 2 Pro is having a tough time keeping stable even with one camera. When flying, as long as you are moving it slowly and steady, the handle is really good. You are still in control of your drone movement. I will never recommend anyone to fly with two 360 cameras, but just one like the Insta360 One X2 or GoPro MAX is very doable on the Mavic 3. The flight time will be obviously shorter. It dropped from 40 minutes to about 25 minutes, but it's still significantly higher than the Mavic 2 Pro, thanks to the higher capacity milliamp batteries. So, investing in the Mavic 3 or Mavic 3 Cine is a no-brainer for any 360 videographers. DJI also confirms that the 360 photo feature you all love in the Mavic 2 Pro is also coming in Mavic 3 with enhanced feature. If you like to take 360 photo like me on Facebook, then this can also be a really good reason why you invest in the Mavic 3. Which mount to choose? So, if you are trying to attach a 360 camera onto Mavic 3 or Mavic 3 Cine, what are some good options out there? What I have here at the bottom is the DPD mount. Originally designed by Luke, but now Hugh from DPD Mounts is creating them. It's 100% US made through the printed attachment with really impressive vibration dampening system. This is the 360 video filmed on this setup with the Insta360 One X2 360 camera. If you want more mounting variety instead of just at the bottom, I would recommend DJI Mount. It attaches to the Mavic 3 four wings like so with a railing system. Then you can choose to mount the camera on top like so or on the bottom. Or combine it with the DPD mount like so to capture both top and bottom 360 and stitch the drone out in post-production. Same idea as the Insta360 VR drone. DJI Mount also has a lot of mounting options for different 360 camera, including a custom case for Insta360 One X2, Qoocam AK, and other brand of camera. It makes attaching a camera super easy. I tested them both, and they are both great options. What are some differences though? DJI Mount, because of the adjustable weight distribution, it is more stable and less front heavy compared to DPD Mount. So it has less impact of flight operation and in general, smoother start and stop, which are very important to VR to avoid motion sickness. It is also lighter than the DPD Mount. It uses GoPro style for mounting, so it is great for GoPro MAX or GoPro Hero 10. On the other hand, DPD mount is heavier, but it also feels a lot more sturdier. You never want your mount to break in the mid-air, so the sturdier option is better. The biggest difference is vibration dampening. DPD mount comes with everything, a full package with vibration rubber that makes sure your footage is silky smooth. For DJI mount, you need to buy that extra 3D printed vibration dampening system. Even that, the result is not good enough as it is 3D printed. They also sell the model for you to create something similar to the DPD mount offers, but you will need to buy all the extra accessory, screw, washer, and rubber on your own on Amazon, which is a hassle. If you just want to buy it and ready to go, then DPD mount is an easier option. For VR 180 camera, DJI mount also has a special mount for Insta360 Evo or any small size VR 180 camera. If you want some great VR 180 aerial video, this is a great option. I highly recommend giving the DJI mount system a try if you are into 3D VR 180 video creation. Hand launch and hand landing. Attaching a payload at the bottom of the drone requires you to hand launch and hand catch your DJI Mavic 3 drone. It is recommended to turn off all your vision sensor and obstacle avoidance system when flying with the 360 camera. But in Mavic 3, DJI is not allowing you to turn off the bottom sensor. Very strange. So when you sneak behind your hovering drone and try to grab the Mavic 3, it will fly away. So don't do that. So how to hand catch it? So see, if you lie, try to sneak behind it, you just fly away. Look at that, you just fly away. Even if you turn everything on, you just fly away. So you have to get your hand up like that and slowly control it down. Don't move your hand. And fly in your hands, that easy to hand catch it. Taking off is actually very easy. Just put your drone out like so, The other hand, just hold down the auto takeoff button, then the drone will launch like so, and hover. Extension pole. At this point, I am not recommend using any extension pole on your 360 camera with your Mavic 3, as you see right here. It creates a pendulum effect and it's getting worse. Mavic 2 Pro actually auto-correct itself and never had this issue. So I assume it is just a very beta firmware right now for the DJI Mavic 3. DJI should correct that as the enterprise drone does have the ability to carry extra payload and can operate in extreme winds. I noted this happened even without payload when a gust of wind hit sideways of the drone. So before a new firmware update, I wouldn't recommend flying Mavic 3 in extreme, unpredicted high wind weather. Mavic 3 has a world most advanced vision sensing optical avoidance system. This is great if you use your drone as it intends to be. But we are not here. Carrying a camera on the bottom of your drone will trigger obstacle avoidance, as you see right here. When I turn on the brake and make the drone to go right, it won't go smoothly, it will brake. When I turn on the bypass and try to make the drone fly left or right again, it will immediately make the drone go crazy and jump up and go forward. So it is recommended to turn off all your obstacle avoidance completely, so your drone can behave normally and the pilot is in full control, not the AI. Since now you are flying without obstacle avoidance, please make sure your flight path is absolutely clear without any obstacles and fly with extreme caution. Also, I want to point out to all the Mavic 2 Pro pilot right here, Mavic 3 controller is extremely sensitive compared to Mavic 2. So make sure your thumb is not trigger happy, especially when you are closer to obstacle when the obstacle avoidance system are turned off. If you want to learn how to fly a 360 camera with any drone, how to stabilize your 360 VR drone footage in the post-production process, and how to remove your drone to create a fully immersive experience inside a VR headset, check this tutorial for Adobe Premiere and this tutorial for DaVinci Resolve. What I teach you here is for hobbyists only. If you want to film 360 video with a drone professionally, I will highly recommend hiring our FAA certified drone pilot who operate with a professional drone like what you see right here, the DJI Inspire 2 or the DJI M600 for bigger size VR camera, or the free flight system Alter X with the Insta360 Titan. We also provide end-to-end post-production services to help you to remove your drone, stabilizing it, removing jello and jitter due to rolling shutter, and add VFX in Unreal or Blender. Check out our full service website in the description down below. If you want to learn 360 VR filmmaking and start your own production studio to capture the growing demand in the metaverse, don't forget to check out our 360 VR filmmaking masterclass right here. We will have a more detailed review and workflow tutorial on the DPD Mount right here and the DJI Mount, including how to combine them together to create some impossible shot for your social media. If you are into FPV or racing drone, you don't want to miss the next tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe and give this video a big thumb up. Kimchi works really hard for your likes. At least you can give him a thumb up and fight against the Mavic 3. Every 10 new thumb up, Kimchi will get a treat. So smash that thumb up button and help Kimchi to get fat. And I will see you next time.